Hello friends, in this session we are going to study about the chemical kinetics. This is the table of content that we learn in this session, that is definition of chemical kinetics, reaction rate, units of rate and rate laws. Before we learn this content, first we have to understand what is the chemistry and how it is related to the chemical kinetics. I know you all know that what do you mean by chemistry, but I have a mature definition of chemistry for you. That is, chemistry is the branch of science that deals with the scientific study of composition, properties, structure and change of matter. I would say this is the mature definition of chemistry because it includes the all studies. It includes the all studies of matter, like scientific study of composition of matter, the scientific study of properties of matter, scientific study of structure of matter and scientific study of transformation of matter. We know that by its nature chemistry is concerned with change, means the raw materials are converted into products by chemical reaction. We know that raw materials have identical properties and we are going to produce the product which possess the desired properties. Okay, so means substance with the well-defined properties are converted by chemical reactions into other substances with the different properties. So that's why for any chemical reaction, chemists try to find out the three most important things. Number one is feasibility of the chemical reaction. Number two is extent to which a reaction will proceed. And number three is the speed of reaction. I will explain each one by one. Number one is feasibility of the chemical reaction. And feasibility of the chemical reaction that can be predicted by thermodynamics. કોઈ પણ રાસાયણિક પ્રક્રિયા થશે કે ન થશે એની માહિતી આપણને કોણ આપશે? થર્મોડાયનેમિક્સ આપશે. બિકોઝ યુ ઓલ હેડ લર્ન ઇન ધ પ્રિવિયસ યર ધ વેલ્યુ ઓફ ડેલ્ટા જી. If the value of delta G less than 0, means if the value of delta G is negative, then the reaction is spontaneous. So the value of delta G define the feasibility of the chemical reactions. That's why here written, reaction is feasible when delta G less than 0 at constant temperature and pressure. So this is the first most important thing which is tried to find out by chemist. Number two, extent to which a reaction will proceed, that can be determined from chemical equilibrium. Matlab koi pan prakriya ketla anse agad vadse eni mahiti apanne kon apse? Rasayanik santulan. To rasayanik santulan upar thi apne પ્રક્રિયા કેટલા અંશે આગળ વધશે એની માહિતી મેળવી શકીએ. ધ એક્સટેન્ટ ટુ વિચ રિએક્શન વિલ પ્રોસીડ, દેટ કેન બી ડિટરમાઇન્ડ ફ્રોમ કેમિકલ ઇક્વિલિબ્રિયમ. એન્ડ થર્ડ મોસ્ટ ઇમ્પોર્ટન્ટ થિંગ ઇઝ સ્પીડ ઓફ રિએક્શન. વોટ ઇઝ ધ સ્પીડ ઓફ રિએક્શન? ટાઈમ ટેકન બાય અ રિએક્શન ટુ રીચ ધ ઇક્વિલિબ્રિયમ. એટલે પ્રક્રિયાએ સંતુલને પહોંચવા લીધેલો સમય, જેને પ્રક્રિયાની ઝડપ કહેવામાં આવે. સો ધીસ થ્રી થિંગ્સ આર મોસ્ટ ઇમ્પોર્ટન્ટ વિચ ઇઝ ટ્રાય ટુ ફાઇન્ડ આઉટ બાય કેમિસ્ટ ફોર એની કેમિકલ રિએક્શન. along with the feasibility of the chemical reaction and extent to which a reaction will proceed, it is equally important to know the rate of chemical reaction and factor controlling the rate of reaction for its complete understanding. Not only the feasibility and extent, it is equally important to know the rate of chemical reaction as well factor controlling the rate of reaction for the complete understanding of any chemical reactions. For example, which parameter determine as to how rapidly food gets spoiled? So this question can be answered by branch of physical chemistry that deals with the study of rate of reaction and their mechanism, called as chemical kinetics. So what is the definition of chemical kinetics? Chemical kinetics is the branch of physical chemistry that deals with the study of rate of reaction and their mechanism. રાસાયણિક ગતિકીમાં આપણે પ્રક્રિયાના વેગનો અભ્યાસ તેમજ પ્રક્રિયાની ક્રિયાવિધિનો અભ્યાસ કરતા હોઈએ છીએ. અને રાસાયણિક ગતિકી એ ભૌતિક રસાયણશાસ્ત્રની શાખા છે જેમાં આપણે પ્રક્રિયાના વેગનો અને પ્રક્રિયાની ક્રિયાવિધિનો અભ્યાસ કરતા હોઈએ છીએ. ધ વર્ડ કાઇનેટિક્સ ઇઝ ડિરાઇવ્ડ ફ્રોમ ધ ગ્રીક વર્ડ કાઇનેસિસ. વોટ ઇઝ ધ મિનિંગ ઓફ કાઇનેસિસ? ધ મિનિંગ ઓફ કાઇનેસિસ ઇઝ movement. Okay, so chemical kinetics help us to understand how chemical reaction occurs. But which informations we are getting from the thermodynamics as well as from the chemical kinetics? Thermodynamics tells only about the feasibility of the reaction. Thermodynamics tells only about the feasibility of reaction, whereas chemical kinetics tells about the rate of reaction. For example, thermodynamic data indicates the diamond shall convert to graphite. Means here the transformation of diamond into graphite. But in reality, the conversion rate is slow. But in reality, the conversion rate is so slow that the change is not perceptible at all. Therefore, the most of the people think that the diamond is forever, but it is not true. Diamond shall convert to graphite, that information we are getting from thermodynamic data. And that is true. But in reality, the conversion rate is so slow that the change is not perceptible at all. Therefore, the people think that diamond is forever. So from this topic, now from this topic, we are reaching the conclusion. That is, kinetic study not only help us to determine the speed of chemical reaction, but also describe the condition by which the reaction rate can be altered. Means, we have number of factors like concentration, temperature, pressure, catalyst. These factors affect the rate of reaction. These factors alter the rate of reaction. Means, these factors increase the rate of reaction as well as decrease the rate of reaction. It depends upon the condition of reaction. Now, next topic is the reaction rate. So, in this topic, first you have to understand the definition of rate of reaction. That is defined as the change in the concentration of any reactant or product per unit time. What is the definition of rate of reaction? The rate of reaction is defined as the change in concentration of any of the reactant or products per unit time. એટલે કે એકમ સમયમાં કોઈ પણ પ્રક્રિયક અથવા નિપજની સાંદ્રતાનો ફેરફાર પ્રક્રિયાનો દર કહેવાય. For that, let's us consider a simple reaction. That is, A will gives B. Here, the concentration of reactant A decreases and that of the B increases as the time passes. Here, the concentration of reactant A decreases and that of the B increases as the time passes. જેમ જેમ સમય પસાર થતો જશે તેમ તેમ પ્રક્રિયક એની સાંદ્રતામાં ઘટાડો થશે, જ્યારે નિપજ બીની સાંદ્રતામાં વધારો થશે. ફોર અ ગિવન રિએક્શન ધ રેટ ઓફ રિએક્શન મે બી ઇક્વલ ટુ ધ રેટ ઓફ ડિસઅપિયરન્સ ઓફ એ, એટલે કે એનો અદૃશ્ય થવાનો દર ઇઝ ઇક્વલ ટુ રેટ ઓફ અપિયરન્સ ઓફ બી, એટલે કે બીનો દ્રશ્ય થવાનો વેગ. સો મેથેમેટિકલી વી કેન રાઇટ ધીસ ડેફિનેશન ઇન ફોર્મ ઓફ ધીસ. રેટ ઇઝ ઇક્વલ ટુ માઇનસ ડી એ બાય ડી ટી ઇઝ ઇક્વલ ટુ પ્લસ ડી બી બાય ડી ટી. હિયર ડી એ ઇઝ ધ ચેન્જ ઇન કન્સન્ટ્રેશન, હિયર ધ ડી બી ઇઝ ચેન્જ ઇન કન્સન્ટ્રેશન ઓફ પ્રોડક્ટ with respect to time. Okay, so rate is equal to minus dA by dt indicates the rate of disappearance of A. Rate is equal to plus dB by dt indicates the rate of appearance of B. The most important thing is sign. Here rate is equal to minus dA by dt in which the sign is negative. This negative sign indicates that there is a decrease in a concentration of reactant A. Decrease in a concentration of reactant A. But here, the plus sign indicates that there is a increase in the concentration of product B. So, minus sign indicates the decrease in concentration of A and plus sign indicates the increase in concentration of B. So, this is all about the reaction rate. Now, next topic is the unit of rate. It is expressed as reaction rate has the concentration divided by time. We know that we express the concentration in mole per liter, but time may be given in any convenient unit like second, minutes, hours, days, or possible years. Therefore, the unit of reaction rate may be mole into liter inverse into second. Mole into liter inverse into minute inverse, minute, and mole into liter inverse into hour inverse. I will repeat. The unit of reaction rate may be written as mole into liter inverse into second inverse, mole into liter inverse into minute inverse, and mole into liter inverse into hour inverse, and so on. Now, this is the last topic of this session, that is rate laws. By a study of numerous reaction, it is shown that the rate of reaction is directly proportional to the reactant concentration. Each concentration being raised to some power. I will repeat. The rate of reaction is directly proportional to the reactant concentration. Each concentration being raised to some power. Okay. Now I would like to explain this rate of reaction by taking a simple reaction. So let's us consider a simple reaction. A will give B. Thus, for a substance A undergoing reaction, the rate of reaction is written as rate is proportional to concentration of A raised to power n. Or you can write rate is equal to k into concentration of A raised to n. Here the k is rate constant for the reaction. Now I would like to explain the rate law by taking another example, that is 2A plus B will gives product. Here, so we can write the rate of reaction as rate is equal to k into concentration of A raised to power m, b into concentration of B into power n. So here the equation, here the both equation 1 and 2 provides the information regarding the relationship between the rate of reaction and reactant concentration. Okay, now follow the definition of rate of reaction. Here written is rate of reaction is directly proportional to reactant concentration. So here we are writing rate is equal to k into concentration of A and concentration of B, with each concentration being raised to some power. Here the power of concentration of A is m and power of concentration of B is n. So rate of reaction is written as rate is equal to k into concentration of A raised to power m and concentration of B raised to power n. An expression which shows how the reaction rate is related to concentration. An expression which shows how the reaction rate is related to concentration is called as rate law or rate equation. So which informations we are getting from the rate law? The relationship between the rate of reaction and reactant concentration. Here the written is an expression which shows how reaction rate is related to concentration is called as rate equation or rate law. So equation number 1 and equation number 2 is called as rate law or rate equations. The power of concentration N or M in the rate law is usually small whole integer number like 1, 2, 3, or it can be fractional. It can be integer number or it can be fractional. We have two examples. Example number one, the reaction is here. H2 gas reacts with iodine to form twice Hi. So how to write the rate law for this particular reaction? So rate law is written as rate is equal to K into concentration of H2 into concentration of I2. So by this way, we can write the rate law for this particular reaction. We have another example, that is the conversion of NO2 to NO and oxygen, means twice mole of NO2 is converted into twice mole of NO with the liberation of dioxygen gas. So rate law can be written from this reaction is rate is equal to K into concentration of NO2 raised to 2. So by this way we can write the rate law for any chemical reaction. Thank you.